Okay guys, welcome back. Another EGGNS emulator, Nintendo Switch emulator for Android with the latest update 1.0.5 on Poco F1. This is a stock Poco. Everything stock. Android 12.0.2, Android 10. MI 12.0.2.0. This is the latest global update. Everything stop. I am going to test 3 Pokemon game. Let's begin. Pokemon Let's Go, Pikachu, Pokemon Shield, and Pokemon Sword. Dog Mode, Auto Skip, the frame skipping, and try to off everything. So slow. Plenty FPS. Snapdragon 845. Even Snapdragon 845 also slow. This is a stock Poco. Just remember that. Normally I remove the thermal file to avoid thermal throttling. Let me do the game setting first. FPS. Then I guess. Okay. too. That's a Pikachu. Throw the ball, just like the Pokemon game. Pikachu! Pokeball. What? First throw. Pikachu. Mustang. Pika. 10 fps, slow 13. Let's guess that Pokemon monster. How slow the response. Very slow. Slow, slow, slow. SD845, slow. Freeze. Okay, next game. Pokemon Shield. Everything freeze. I say freeze. Okay, next one. Pokemon Shield. Very bad optimization on the RAM usage. Even on Poco F1, it's slow. Thank you. really, really slow. Took forever to load the screen. Where's my bag? Where's my bag? It freeze. One FPS, zero FPS. Forty-three, 45, handy back maybe 47. Stock Poco with the thermal file still inside the system. See, freeze. I say freeze. Wow, that's very bad. That's very bad emulator. System freeze. Max Pokemon SWAT. Hey. br f. That sucks. Over here again. 10 minutes resting over here. Really, really slow. Pokemon SWAT. Same as Pokemon Shield. Almost similar game, a bit different ending, and still slow. This is not playable. Wait. Still maintain 40 plus. If you remove the thermal file, wait for the pawn to explode. Battery 40. Dangerous. Lagging. Zero APS, same as Pokemon Shield. If SD845 at zero APS and slow, what more to say? The lower CPU, the mid-range. This is a flagship CPU. Still slow. On the 4GB of RAM, it will crash. Recommended 6GB. almost 10 minutes gone on this scene. Come on, come on, let's move. Hey! Move, come on. Move, move, move. Not yet. Zero FPS. Zero. Now. Come on, that's fine. Boring. How are you going to play like that? At the moment, 105, 106, 107, 108, 110. Yeah, maybe this game still the same performance. What the hell? Come on, let's move. Move, 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 move. 1 FPS on it, 2 FPS. One FPS. Now 11. Going back to zero. No way, no way, no way. Okay. 2 FPS. Snapdragon 845. Even the 865, more or less. Why? Not yet, this emulator. Maybe the 2D game not a problem, but the 3D game like this, sure, still heavy for it to run. Come on, come on. 0 FPS. To even to exit the game, really, really hard. No. Even you switch off the power button, it's not respond. See? Still running at the background. One back. That's very bad. All the RAM resource gone. Zero. Okay. Dangerous. The battery 42, 43. Now switch off. Poco is dead. Wah, wah, wah. Restart. Phew. Fah. Bad. Very bad emulator. If you got a PC, then install Yuzu or Ryujin. These two emulators are better. even it run on a laptop. Okay, that's it. A bullshit controller almost killed my Poco. See, 50 degrees, 44, 45, that dangerous. I don't want it to reach 50 on the battery, otherwise it may explode. Very hot. That is hot. Even the stock Poco is hot. What more to say, the if I remove the thermal file, even worse. Thermal throttling still getting hot. Okay, that's it. Once again, thank you for watching. And one more time, don't request this game again.